Hello everybody, I hope you are enjoying this year's developer conference. My name is Josh Shires and I'm an instructional designer working for the Milestone Learning and Performance team. In this short presentation, I will walk you through a few of the most important resources available to those who are new to the Milestone Integration Platform Software Development Kit, or MIP SDK, and the Xprotect VMS product and video surveillance in general. We will review these main areas that should help you get started on the right foot. First, we'll look at the main web page for the MIP SDK. We'll look at where to find documentation. We'll review how to communicate with other developers and Milestone team members on the developer forum. And finally, we'll look at the available e-learning courses that my team is most focused on developing. The MIP SDK product page on the Milestone website is the most obvious starting point. Most of you have probably already visited it when you signed up for this conference. Here, you can most importantly download both the regular MIP SDK and the mobile SDK. Additionally, you'll also be able to find the MIP SDK Getting Started guide, plus links to other resources. There is no cost to download and use the SDKs. And the same goes for the free version of Xprotect VMS Essential Plus. After you have downloaded and installed the SDK, you'll most likely want to take a look at the documentation. Here, you can find an overview of application samples that demonstrate various functionality, as well as information about the three different integration approaches and the API documentation itself. The Milestone Developer Forum is where you can interact with other developers and Milestone employees. If you have a problem, there's a good chance that you're not the only one. It's also a good place to learn about what other developers are doing and how they solve problems that you yourself may face. Milestone Learning and Performance have created a training track for new developers. It's a collection of self-paced online courses that cover both the basics of IP-based video surveillance topics, what Xprotect VMS is, and of course, how to get started with the MIP SDK. These resources are free to access and can be found on the Milestone Learning Portal by creating a My Milestone account or via the Milestone Systems Learning YouTube channel. Let's take a closer look at these resources. The first three courses in the developer track are for those who are new to Milestone's Xprotect VMS products or new to the industry of IP-based video surveillance. These are some of the most popular courses we have and are a great way to get up to speed. Fundamentals of IP surveillance systems discusses topics like video codecs, networking, bandwidth, storage, and servers and workstations. As a client-server-based architecture, getting started with Xprotect Smart Client covers end-user operators viewing live and recorded data, as well as exporting evidence. The first course in the MIP SDK specific lineup is Getting Started with the MIP SDK. It is an introductory course for those who have no previous experience of the MIP SDK. Its main goal is to help you select the most appropriate integration approach. The three choices are: 1. Plugin integrations. These are .NET assemblies running inside Xprotect VMS as plugins. 2. Component integrations. This is another .NET oriented choice, but the application runs in your own application environment. And finally, protocol integrations. These are both OS and language agnostic. Once you have decided on the integration approach, the rest is much easier. Plugin integrations are .NET assemblies that run inside Xprotect VMS as plugins. These plugins can be running in different environments of Xprotect VMS. If running in the Xprotect Smart Client, they are called client plugins and are typically used by the end user operators of Xprotect VMS. Admin plugins in the admin plugins run in the XProtect management client and are typically used for configuration tasks by administrators. Some plugins must always be running. These plugins, called background plugins, run typically in the event server, even if they can also run in the management client and smart client. Background plugins also typically handle communication with external applications. Developing MIP SDK plugin integrations covers each of these plugin types. This course will give you an overview of the Visual Studio template for plugin integrations and use it as the basis for all exercises. If you complete the whole course, you will have performed several common tasks that most integrations require. Component integrations are another .NET-based integration approach. In this case, the application that interacts with XProtect VMS is running in your own environment, as opposed to plugin integrations, where the application is running inside XProtect VMS. Component integrations are an easy way to add commonly used XProtect VMS functionality to your own applications. This includes viewing video or other data, listening to and/or triggering events, and much more. This course will go over the use of the Visual Studio template for component integrations and how you can accomplish some of these very common tasks. This should help you get a good feel for the workflow and to start digging deeper on your own. The MIP driver framework eLearning is primarily targeted towards device manufacturers whose products don't currently have full support in XProtect VMS or any support at all. The driver frameworks allows anyone to create a device driver that can be thought of as a recording server plugin. This is an important step in keeping the open platform truly open. There are far too many devices out there for Milestone to create drivers for, especially for niche products. The driver framework allows the device driver to support all of the conventional data, like video and audio. In addition, it supports inputs and outputs, as well as metadata and custom device features. Metadata is perhaps the most transformational aspect in the industry for increasing situational awareness to conventional video-only applications by augmenting the data with various kinds of data from, for example, temperature sensors, video analytics, and all kinds of IoT devices. Better accuracy in event detection leads to improved productivity and user satisfaction. Thanks for taking time to attend this introductory presentation about some of the fundamental resources available to help you get started with developing new and exciting applications for XProtect VMS. Now get out there and develop.